to go everywhere and know everyone and never let a weekend go to waste. Buck Henry and Dave Thomas.
Good evening, I'm Buck Henry. And I'm Dave Thomas, and welcome to Weekend Tonight. Thank you. You know, a visit to the famed Russian Tea Room is a must for New York tourists, but it's small change compared to the kind of spectacular two-day bash surrounding a major Russian funeral. Dave and I were lucky enough to be included on the exclusive list of VIPs invited to the reception in Red Square in honor of the late Yuri Andropov, or Andy, as he is known to Dave and me. There's a picture of us there, see?
Yes, and after viewing the body in the traditional open casket, British Prime Minister Maggie Thatcher broke both of us up with her witty observation, "To my mind, two things should always be kept closed: toothpaste tubes and Russian coffins."
But the incorrigible Maggie didn't stop there. At the party later, after chug-a-lugging more than her share of 120-proof Stolichnaya vodka, she broke the news about Princess Di's pregnancy and said that it wouldn't surprise her if the baby looked like New York City's Mayor Ed Koch.
Then Andropov's successor, Konstantin Cherenko, or Tino, as we like to call him, demonstrated some of his famous Russian party tricks, which included stringing a balalaika behind his back and smearing 3,000 rubles worth of black caviar on his face and doing an impression of Al Jolson singing Mammy.
Also present were the irascible Canadian Prime Minister Pierre Elliott Trudeau, fun-loving Swedish Premier Olaf Palme, and wisecracking West German leader Helmut Ich bin ein Hellraiser Kohl, who capped the evening off by showing us his surgical scars. Later, we were all arrested by the KGB, questioned, tortured, and thrown onto Air Force One, where, hungover but still laughing, Vice President George Bush proclaimed it to be the best funeral of a Soviet leader he'd ever attended and hoped there'd be another one real soon.
And so do we.
Well, Dave.
Yes, Buck.
The nominations for the 56th Academy Awards were announced yesterday, and we at Weekend Tonight would like to congratulate all of the nominees.
And because you'll be seeing all of them on countless TV interviews in the weeks to come, Weekend Tonight took the time to visit an ex-Academy Award winner who was not fortunate enough to have been nominated this time around.
Miss Julie Andrews.
That's right.
We managed to get Julie Andrews' room number from the front desk clerk for a Finsky. They don't normally do that. Let's hope Miss Andrews is in.
Oh, hello. Buck Henry.
And Dave Thomas.
For Weekend Tonight.
A couple of questions, please.
I'm sorry, Entertainment Tonight.
Weekend Tonight. We just want to talk to you
just
for a few
couple of questions,
if you
please.
Oh, you don't mind waiting here. I'm on a long distance call.
Well, we'll wait. Problem.
Could you turn that spotlight on?
No problem. We'll just wait in here with you.
Hello, love. It's two gentlemen. They've come here for an interview. I don't know where they're from. Is it Weekend Tonight?
Yes.
Yes, Weekend Tonight. Well, I don't know. Yes. Well, we've had people like this before, haven't we? Well, we could talk. Should I mention the, Okay, charm. As charming as ever, yes. All right.
Put it in!
Listen, Blake, why don't I take this in the other room? If you don't mind, this is a private call.
We'll wait right here.
Yeah.
I'll just die if they sell my lucky salami.
No, let's not talk about it now. I'm coming in to LA in 5 hours, and I don't... Really, can we not talk about this later? I'll hang up. I'll see you... Yes, the airport. All right, bye, love.
Miss Andrews, was that Blake Edwards, your writer-director husband?
Yes, it was. He doesn't seem to remember setting up this interview.
Well, oh. I can't understand that. Probably his secretary forgot to tell him.
Yes. Just a slip-up. Anyway, we're here. Let's make the best of it.
And I have a flight to catch soon.
Well, I'm sure you do, and this will only take a little while. First, we want to congratulate you for The Man Who Loved Women. I know it's a picture that's been critically lambasted, that not very many people have gone to see it, and those who have been pretty disappointed.
Well,
but who cares?
Has very bad luck.
We loved it.
We adored it.
We want you to know we wish you were up for an Academy Award just like you have been in times gone by.
I hope it's not too personal, but in the movie SLB, you did something that nobody ever expected you would do. You went topless. I, for one, was delighted. What took you so long to take that plunge?
I thought it was only fair to wait until my lovely little fans of Mary Poppins had grown up, grown their own breasts,
and then I thought it was time to show mine.
Julie, we know you've got a great body, and we also think you've got one of the greatest voices in the world. Isn't that right, Dave?
Absolutely. You've got an unprecedented range. 6 octaves, I think, that nobody can sing like that. Would you favor us with a song right now, Julie?
That'd be wonderful.
My funny Vanna.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry to stop you on this, but we have to get something that we won't have royalty problems with. We won't have to pay a lot of money for. Could it be something in the public domain?
Something folksy, an old song.
Right.
Do your boobs hang low?
Oh, hang on. I think we're in trouble with that
word.
Yeah. Don't you think?
Yes.
Do your hooters hang low? Do they wobble to and fro? Can you tie them in a knot? Can you tie them in a bow? Can you throw them over your shoulder like a continental soldier? Do your hooters hang low?
Bravo.
Yes, Julie Andrews, she'll always be our fair lady.
Indeed you will, Buck. This coming Monday is President's Day, and millions of Americans will be taking advantage of the 3-day weekend to visit their favorite presidential libraries and museums. The figures are in from last weekend, and here are the nation's top grossing presidential museums.
Wow, a lot of surprises in that one. But Dave, while those of a more intellectual bent are enjoying America's presidential archives, our nation's morons and lowlifes will be throwing away their money at innumerable tawdry and depressing night spots. The results are in, and here are last week's top-grossing dives and hellholes.
Well, frivolity, levity, and hilarity, that can only mean one thing, the shuttle.
You're right, Dave. You know, there was a regular laugh riot last week when the crew of the Space Shuttle Challenger played the first practical joke in outer space. And for those of you who missed it, here's exactly what happened. The whole thing started when Bruce McCandless completed his spacewalk and everyone else decided to have a little fun at his expense.
McCandless requesting disengage airlock to report Challenger. McCandless out.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't quite catch that name.
Come on, guys. That's not funny.
What's the password?
Requesting disengage airlock. Houston Control, this is McCandless. They won't let me back in the Challenger out.
Who is it?
McCandless. I'll come around the other side and drill a hole through the lavatory wall. McCandless out. I'm reboarding the Challenger now. Very funny, guys. What do you boys like to join me in the airlock? McCandless out. You're a bad astronaut. Bad. Don't ever do that to me again. Bad, bad astronaut. Keep away from my umbilical cord, you pervert.
Well,
they have a lot of fun up there, don't they?
They sure do. Space looks like a riot.
Absolutely.
For the past few years, a bevy of celebrities have written books, recorded albums, videotapes, video discs, and have even given lectures on how they stay in shape.
All of which brings us to a new feature on Weekend Tonight, Workouts of the Stars. And for our first installment, we visited a very colorful, quite overweight star who showed us exactly how he keeps in shape. That's right. It's that phenomenon of the English pop scene, Boy George, who stays in shape by boxing, like so many other singers have. Elvis Presley, Perry Como, Peter, Paul, and Mary. Let's watch some more. George, we've only got a few seconds between rounds, so let me ask you some questions.
Yes, go ahead.
What do I call you? Do I call you George or Boy George?
Actually, my friends call me Boy.
Boy.
You can call me Boy Buck.
And I will.
No, call yourself Boy Buck.
I see what you mean.
That could be your name, Boy Buck.
Boy, how long have you been fighting?
As long as I've been wearing these clothes.
Boy George, what is it you like most about boxing?
Oh, I just get to go in there and beep, 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 beep.
You throw a lot of punches, but you rarely take a punch. Why is that?
Gotta protect the porcelain.
Have you considered a film career?
Yes, I have, in fact.
Would you play a singer or a boxer?
Well, I have an idea for a film I could do called Boy Rocky.
Really?
Actually, I do an impression of Sly Stallone.
Oh, could we hear it?
Sure. Adrian. Bye-bye.
There's the bell.
Why you go? That's it.
Boy George by a knockout, a great singer, a great boxer, a great karma chameleon. This is Buck Henry for Weekend Tonight.
Thanks, Boy George. And thank you, and good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.